Okay, hello and good morning, everyone. Welcome to JFD Traders Espresso with me, Darius and Anucauskas. Today's the 26th of March, 2020. So, yep, welcome, everyone. Welcome to this Thursday's morning recorded session. Where, as always, we're going to have a quick look at the markets, a few of the charts, a few of the charts that we looked at yesterday. Probably this is going to be more a quick review of the instruments that we looked at yesterday, because just wanted to kind of update you on what's happening there, because there are some interesting potential setups. Right now, guys, as always, before we jump into the charts, let's quickly have a read through our risk disclaimers. So, the content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. So, as always, I'll give you a few seconds to read the rest, and we can continue. Also, just a very quick mentioning of our JFD YouTube channel, to which you can always subscribe to in order not to miss any of our upcoming videos, and of course our JFD Bank website, and specifically our JFD research page, which we update on a daily basis. So yep, feel free to visit us here on jfdbank.com and click on the research tab right there. Now then, quick refresh of what's happening here globally in regards to the coronavirus. Now, the number continues to rise, and to be honest, with such a speed, probably by the end of today, we might reach already the half a million number here. So, in regards to total people affected. Again, we'll see. We'll see how this number is going to look later on. We'll have a look at this one in my traders' tea time later on, 14:15 GMT. For now, guys, it doesn't look good. We've already surpassed that 20,000 death mark, for now, the only thing is we can do is try to keep it safe. Stay safe, guys. Stay, try to protect your health. Now then, let's jump into the charts. Quick mentioning here of the FTSE 100. Now, I looked at this one yesterday, and you can see that the index managed to close the day in the positive territory, but still below this downside line taken from the high of the 24th of February. So, in a way, again, as I've mentioned previously, as long as this downside line continues to hold, then yes, we will aim for lower levels, especially if the price starts falling back below the 5,500 zone here, and then we will start aiming for these slightly lower levels, the ones that I've mentioned a couple of days ago, like the 5,295 or the 5,195, these potential breakout points previously potential breakout points. Now these resistance areas will become nice areas of support, or should I say, could become nice areas of support. So, in other words, guys, if the price starts falling back below the 5,500 zone, then yes, aim for these slightly lower levels. Looking at the cash index right now, we can see that the index is balancing around the 5,530 mark. So basically, just slightly above this key area that we're keeping a close eye on. And this, by the way, this 5,500 level, just let me show you what I'm talking about here. Let me just jump back into the daily chart. And this 5,500 zone is the lowest point of 2016. So something to consider, something to keep an eye on, guys. But again, for now, it's still balancing slightly above it. So let's see how this is going to play out. If this index decides to break this downside line here and pushes above the 5,788 territory, that's, by the way, the lowest point of June 2016, and then yes, we will aim for some higher levels. For now, it's slightly off the table, and let's see how it's going to play out near this 5,500 level. The German DAX. Now, The German index closed yesterday below the downside lines here. So let me just quickly adjust this because it's skewed here a little bit. So it's still closed below this downside line. However, it did manage to break above it temporarily, but still kind of remains below this downside line. Looking at the cash index right now, we can see that the price is currently balancing around the 9,645-46 zone. So basically, it's back below some of these interesting levels here. Let me just is back below this little low here, the little the low of yesterday, which is around the 9,460-61 zone here. So that's the low of yesterday. It's now below the low of yesterday here. So in a way, guys, for now, be very careful. Again, the same story. As long as this downside line remains intact, we will aim for lower levels again, especially if the price drops back below the 9,141 zone. I spoke about this level yesterday in my videos, and in order to aim for the downside again, we need to see a drop below this, and then yep, we'll get a little bit more comfortable with these possible areas of support, which are the first good one will be around the 8,700 zone, and then yep, we will aim for that, for those lower levels like the 8,255 mark, around the 8,255. So yep, that's gonna be our next target. For now, again, it's very difficult here. In order to aim for higher levels, we would like to see a push above this 10,280 zone, and I've mentioned this one previously. That's basically the lowest point of December 2018. So yep, keep your eyes on that one. So now then, jumping into WTI oil, very quick update on this and looking at this 4-hour chart. So in a way, what I kept saying throughout this whole week, basically, we're, as long as we remain below this 26.08 level, then yes, we could see a further declines, especially if we see a monthly candle closing below this 26.08. That's, by the way, the lowest point of 2016 here. So If the price remains below that territory, then especially forward in closes the month below that territory, then further declines could be possible. We could then test again that psychological 20 zone, but if that fails to withhold, then yep, again, like I said, further declines are possible. Looking at the 4-hour chart on this instrument here, you can see that the commodity is getting into somewhat of a squeeze. So in a way, that's why we're not going to do anything here. We're just going to continue observing this one and waiting until we see a clear pop through one of the levels. In terms of the upside here, we would still need to see a push above that 26.08 level, and then we could target some higher levels. Hey, however, for now, as I said, we are a little bit on the neutral side here and waiting to see which way this is going to break out to. In a way, you could draw something like a triangle here, guys. It's not an ideal one, but nevertheless, we'll keep an eye on this here. So jumping into gold, gold is declining a little bit. So this is kind of working and going in line with what I was talking about yesterday. Yesterday was what I was saying, that in a way, after having such a nice spur to the upside here, the commodity now, the precious metal, is declining, and it's quite a healthy decline. So everything's fine here. Basically, as long as it remains above the 1575 territory or this upside support line taken from the low of the 22nd of May, as long as it remains above this territory, then yes, we will continue targeting the upside. So something like this could still be possible, where we could then aim maybe for these highs. And of course, the big question here would be, can we reach the highs of this month, and this way kind of covering all the losses made in the first half of this month? Now, this is, of course, a big question, but for now, it seems that maybe it's not going to be likely unless something changes either tomorrow or in the other two trading days that we have left in March next week. So So yep, something to consider. So, but first, what we're looking here for is maybe a little bit of a larger correction here to the downside, maybe a test of this 1575 territory, and then a rebound and a push higher. Push higher again. For those who are more on the cautious side, you could just wait for a break above the high of this week, the current high of this week, which is around the 1643 zone, and then aim for further upside. For now, like I said, we are a little bit cautious here. We are considering maybe a little bit of a deeper correction to the downside, but yep, if this area holds, this could be a nice push. This could be a nice plateau for the bulls to step in again. If this upside line breaks and the price falls below the 1547 territory, then yes, we will aim for lower levels here. But again, for now, this scenario could be just slightly off the table. Ripple, also very quick update on this. So here we have a very annoying situation. So yesterday I talked about this one, and basically now it's breaking this downside line, but neither with a strong push higher nor with the strong push lower. I mean, it's not really moving away from this downside line easily. So in a way, we can see that it's actually ignoring this line. So now it's basically just entering a range and it's moving sideways. So that's why we're probably going to get rid of this downside line. We're no longer going to keep it on the chart. And for now, we're going to focus mainly on some key areas of support and resistance. So the first area of resistance, of course, this is this one. And I've mentioned this one yesterday. That's the 0.1760. We need to see a nice good pop above this in order to aim for higher levels, because this would confirm a forthcoming higher high. Higher levels could be met. For now, you can see that the crypto is just not moving anywhere. It's just moving sideways a little bit here. And in a way, for the downside, we would like to see a drop below the 0.1450 territory. We could aim for lower levels. So again, guys, for now, keep your eyes on this. Keep your eyes on these two levels. Again, there's not much to talk about here yet until we see a clear breakthrough one of these levels. USDJPY. So this is something interesting, and this is something that I've mentioned yesterday. So I was talking about this level here, the 111.60, which continued to hold, and this area here is acting as a very nice area of resistance. And what I was saying, that if the rate gets a hold up here still and fails to push above it, then we could see a bit of a decline. We could see a move lower, but again, still, if this rate remains above this upside support line here, then there still could be a chance for the bulls to step in and drive this one higher. Now, if this upside line starts breaking and the pair starts, sliding somewhere below this little level here, the 109.64-65 zone, then, yep, we could consider a bit of a larger extension here to the downside. However, for now, we are still, although we are moving away to the downside from this 111.60 territory, we are still above this upside support line taken from the low of 9th of March. So that's why, guys, for now, be very careful and keep your eyes on this one. And as I said, let's see how this is going to play out. But if it starts pushing above this 111.60 territory, then this would confirm a forthcoming higher high, and we could aim for slightly higher levels. By slightly higher levels, I'm currently talking about the highest point of the current highest point of 2020, which is around the 112.23. After that, we'll take it from there. USDCAD. Now, also a very interesting spot here. I've looked at this one this week, and what I was saying, that in a way, because it failed to push above the 1.4536 territory, it has drifted lower and it continued to drift lower. And when I was covering USDCAD in one of my videos this week, I was telling you guys to keep a close eye on this little level here, the 1.43 25 26 zone. And what I was saying, that if we get a nice drop below this, then yep, this could lead towards slightly lower levels. And Initially, we will target this upside support line, which, as you can see, it kind of acted as a good area of support. However, we did get a few breaks, but we didn't really travel below this other level from which we would consider deeper extensions to the downside. So this level here is the 1.4162 mark, so approximately around there. You can see that the pair kind of drifted below this upside line, but still remained above this area of support. So that's what we're looking here for. And by the way, probably let me just adjust this a little bit, because we can capture this just for that extra confirmation. The 1.4145 zone, approximately around there, could even do the trick here for more sellers, because if we see a drop below these two levels, then this is where it could become very ugly for USDCAD, and we could start sliding lower. So that's why for now, yes, we are seeing this one climbing back above this upside line, but be very careful and be very cautious. The way we could play this one out is still all this territory for us will be somewhat of a neutral one. For us to maybe start considering higher levels, we would like to see a push above this 1.4536 zone and then aim for the upside. For now, it's a little bit tricky, guys, I would say, because in a way it could climb a little bit higher here, but let's say if it gets a hold up near this tentative downside line here. Now this is where it could we could see another round of selling here, and basically this pair would be coiling up here inside this little pattern. So and in a way we could even ignore this probably upside line now, because what I'm going to draw here right now is a possible descending triangle. Now very interesting, could be interesting, but again, for now, keep this idea in mind. Don't get me wrong, according to all the textbooks, TA textbooks, these patterns tend to break to the downside, but we've seen this happening many times the opposite way, so that's why we're just going to wait for a breakthrough one of our key levels here. So on the upside, we need to see a push above the 1.4536 zone here, and on the downside, we would like to see a drop below this area right here, which is between the 1.4145 and the 1.4162 zone. So keep your eyes on this one. NZDCHF, very quick update on this one. I talked about this pair yesterday, and basically we were still hanging around above this upside support line taken from the low of the 19th of March, but as you can see, the pair now drifted back down, and it failed to move above this key barrier around the 0.5795. It started drifting lower, and now you can see that it's back below this downside line, so the previous downside line. So in a way, this upside line got violated, so we can get rid of it. Now, the fact that it's traveling back below this downside line, of course, this is raising concerns here of a possibility for it to move higher. However, in order to aim for lower levels, we need to see a drop below the 0.56 level, 56 level first, and then, yep, we'll aim for further declines. For now, waiting for a clear move through one of these. Let me just quickly captured this one. There we go. So waiting for a breakthrough one of these highlighted areas first, and then yep, we'll take it from there. GBPNZD, also a very quick update on what's happening here. For this one, I need a daily chart, and yesterday we remained above this upside line, but what I was saying that we'll still remain neutral in all this situation, because in order for us to aim for higher levels, we need to see a push above this 2.07.64.65 zone here, and in order to aim for the downside, we need to see a break below that psychological 2s level. So, and ideally, we need to see a break, not only a break, but also a daily close below this psychological 2 zone. Because again, for now, it's just kind of moving sideways a little bit here. It does have these little attempts to break this psychological 2 level, but it fails to stay below it. So that's why we would like to see the daily candle staying below it first, and then we could aim for lower levels. For now, this upside support line taken from the low of the 30th of July continues to hold nicely, and Let's see if it can continue doing that. But again, for us to get comfortable with higher levels, we need to see a push above this 2.076465 zone. Excuse me. And finally, EURUSD. So we managed to break the downside line here. Let me just jump into a 4-hour chart. So we managed to break the downside line taken from the high of the 9th of March. And yep, we've managed to also move above this barrier that I talked about yesterday, the 1.0888 level. The push happened, the close at least of a 4-hour candle happened here as well. So now, of course, this increases the chances of a possible move higher towards the 1.095253 zone here. And slightly above that, we do have that 200 EMA here on the 4-hour chart, which also could provide a bit of resistance here for this pair. But initially, of course, it will be a nice good target. So that's why for now, guys, as long as it remains trading above this 1.0888 level, yes, we will aim for higher levels. We're going to keep it careful because, again, don't get me wrong, in this market, any wild news headline could change the whole outlook very quickly. So in a way, for us to consider the downside, we would still need to see a drop below this 1.0777 zone, and then we could target lower levels. For now, we are leaning more towards the upside, especially if it continues to trade above and continues to balance above the 1.0888 level. So keep your eyes on that one, guys. Okay, so I hope you found it useful. Thank you very much for sticking around and watching until the end, guys. I really appreciate your time. Thank you very much, guys, and thank you for all the views and likes. So yep, if you want to join me, let's say, or you want to catch my video later on today, the tea time video, where we're going to have a look at some of these instruments, some new ones as well. And we'll take it from there. We'll see how the market is performing. But for now, I hope you have a wonderful trading day, guys, and stay safe, and be very careful with everything, and especially the market. Anyway, guys, have a wonderful trading day. Thank you very much. And bye-bye.